Hi, this is Scott Garibay, and today I'm going to be talking about the ramifications of our world being a zero-sum game and what that means for us on the side that are saying, okay, we're going to enter into these intense debates online and in person about things that other people think are trivial that we understand are not trivial because of the new shape of our world. Okay, so I want to talk today about three things: cursing, fallacies, and anonymity. All right. Now, my supposition is that the base nature of our world has changed, right? And as American citizens, we live in essentially a society of abundance. There are absolutely many people who are struggling, right? But even many of the people who struggle in America have vehicles and cell phones, and, you know, it's incredibly rare for people to not have enough to eat. And if anybody doesn't have those things, there are absolutely safety nets that aid with that, right? So in this new society that we have, we, you know, in our culture, that we're just not, nobody's running around hitting each other the head with sticks anymore, right? So our battles have shifted to language. And those language battles are happening online and in person over things that a lot of people are saying, you know, there's usually three camps on any of these. You know, Last Jedi is the latest one that blew up, but this happens all the time, right? So there was intense debates about there was three camps on the Last Jedi. Last Jedi was great. The yay Last Jedi camp, the boo Last Jedi camp, and the please stop talking about this camp, okay? And almost every what would seem to be a trivial debate today, these three camps exist. Yay, boo, and be quiet, right? Like, and my point, my whole point is that the be quiet people need to understand that this is healthy for us to have these intense debates about things that seem trivial to them, but are actually very connected and actually very relevant because the shape of our world has changed. And this is where, you know, our contentiousness is coming out in a much more healthy way than we used to do, right? Now, us, as people who are going to participate in intense debate online, we absolutely need a code, right? So, when it comes to battle, right, the most honorable warriors that I can think of in history were the samurai, right? They were incredibly honorable. They had a code. They had the Bushido code. And they said, we do this and we don't do that. Now, it was back in the times, and there were certainly things that they could have added to their code, but their code was strong, and they had a code, and they lived by code. We who are going to partake in intense debates online, we need a code, right? And that code is no cursing, no fallacies, no anonymity, all right? And let me just break them down, all right? So cursing, we don't curse when we get into these intense debates, and the reason why is we are maintaining civility in these debates. Maintaining civility. It's absolutely crucial that we maintain civility, that we treat people with respect. And cursing throws that out the door immediately. It just says, hey, this is a free-for-all. Let's punch below the belt. And it's a terrible way to debate, right? And going forward, you know, anybody who's using cursing in their debating, you can just remove them from the conversation in that everyone has the right to talk, but you don't need to respond to them. You don't need to give any credence to what they're saying. And the reason why is they're not civil, right? So, you know, you don't want to have a conversation with those kind of people, right? It's below our code, okay? No fallacies. You must learn the fallacies, okay? Just Google writing fallacies. You'll see them. Ad hominem, slippery soap, appeal to authority. There's a whole bunch of them, right? We learn the fallacies. We do not use the fallacies, period, right? Now, all of these we're going to struggle with. It's going to be hard to do this. And the samurai struggled with their own code. There were times where they broke them, right? You're not going to be 100% on all this, but you strive to be perfect, right? You always strive to be perfect, right? And no anonymity. When we comment, we do it with our own name, right? We own what we say. And then also, when we deal with anybody else online, and they're saying something behind a mask, they're saying something behind some fake username, we value it 100%. I think there needs to be the ability to hear someone saying something anonymous, because very, very rarely people who are speaking anonymously are saying something important, but it's incredibly rare. the vast of times it is used to use fallacies, to use cursing, and to say things that are ugly and hurtful, right? You know, so always value anonymity at 1/100th of a percent of a credited source, right? So, you know, if somebody says something anonymously, if 99 other people are saying the same thing anonymously, value that at the same rate of one comment that's credited, right? So as we go forward, I truly believe the need for intense debate about things that a lot of people think are trivial is needed and it's healthy, right? But we have to have a code. Those of us who are going to participate in these debates, we need to not curse, we need to not use fallacies, and we need to not use anonymity. I think it's absolutely critical. I want to talk a little bit about the benefits that you will gain from this, right? So the biggest one is, so if you go down this road and you actually take these actions and you get into these intense debates, right? The biggest thing that's going to happen is you're going to learn from failure, right? So there's two things, right? Fighting fit and failure, okay? One, you're going to be fighting fit. In today's society, a perfect example, okay? I have someone who used to be a friend. I'm not in a space where I can really even physically spend time with them anymore. We're, you know, too separated. We don't really run in the same circles anymore. But this person, they used to talk a lot about fights they would get into. And I was like, what? You know, and for a couple of years, I was like, you know, Scott, you never get in any fights nowadays. This guy's always getting in fights, punching people in the face. And I thought, wow, that's really odd, you know? And I realized a little while later, all of it was a crock, right? Like, the reality is, fighting fit, no, in this world does not mean fighting fit, right? You know, if you're a soldier, absolutely. But if you're not a soldier, there's not going to be any fighting. This is the modern world, right? You're not going to punch anybody in the face, and you're not going to get punched in the face. And if you are in any kind of circles where that's happening, that needs to stop immediately. This is the modern world, right? That stuff is 10, 20, 30 years old. Nobody gets punched or is punching anybody anymore. And if you are in those circles, you need to remove yourself from them, right? Fighting fit now is keeping your mind sharp and your language skills high, right? And your ability to debate strong. That's fighting fit. And you need to jump into these and use your code, right? So that you're showing respect at all times and you're giving due respect when you're discussing with people, even intensely, you know? But you keep your mind fighting fit today. Because the reality is, like, we're just not in a world. Like, there haven't been, you know, enemy boots on the ground in America in two centuries, you know? Like, it's crazy. So, you know, so my point is, the benefit of this is you keep your mind fighting fit, right? In addition to that, failure. You're going to get schooled, right? If you go on, especially online, right, you're going to run into people who are smarter than you, right? And we need to get used to and get good at conceding points and saying, oh, you win this conversation, sir, or you win this conversation, ma'am. You know, especially on points, right? And even when you have been swayed, right? When you've been persuaded. And if you're like, I can't be persuaded on anything I believe, then you're doing it wrong. You need to, when you go into an intense debate, you want to persuade the people on the other side of that debate. And you need to be ready to be persuaded if their arguments are sound and logical and correct, right? So we need to open our minds to failing on points and failing on entire arguments, right? And if you're the kind of person who dodges this stuff, man, you're not going to be fighting fit. Not in this world, right? Because fighting fit, you know, that doesn't happen with your body. It happens with your mind now, right? And so I really feel like, you know, we need a code and we need to know the benefits of staying of intense debate, right? That's my take on our world now being a zero-sum game. Take care. Bye-bye.